This episode of the Happy Diabetic Kitchen podcast is sponsored by my diabetes supplier, US Med. US Med offers free shipping and a 90-day supply with every order. See how they can simplify your diabetes care. Simply call 1-877-840-8218. I did, and I can feel the love. Remember, there is a much better solution. US Med. Everyone, I am Chef Robert Lewis, the Happy Diabetic, and welcome to the internet's most delicious cooking podcast, The Happy Diabetic Kitchen. I'm here in the kitchen getting ready to explore a healthy diabetic lifestyle. I want to take the mystery out of healthy cooking and explore some amazing foods and my diabetic journey with all my successes and my challenges. Let me help you live your best happy diabetic lifestyle. And if you're new to the podcast, we want to welcome you. So glad that you're here. And Jason Lewis, our producer of the podcast, and my son is on special assignment. So with that said, let's get into the kitchen and start cooking. In this episode of the podcast, it's all about the right foods that can help you lower your blood glucose and keep it in check. We know that eating has a huge correlation to how your blood glucose levels are. So I'm going to give you some tips that work really great for me. And our recipe of the podcast in this episode will be Holly's amazing, unbelievable, so delicious onion relish of love. You'll find that recipe at happydiabetic.com. Go to the blog and there it will be. So if you're ready to go, let's get cooking. When I think about feeding my body, I think about foods that are high in nutrition. So I'm always going to choose foods that are packed with nutrients, not so much processed. I'm going to share with you some of the fundamentals of eating for a diabetic, healthy lifestyle way of eating. One that will help keep your glucose levels in check. We're going to be talking about greens, dark leafy greens, amazing fruits, vegetables, nuts, oils, protein, and we're going to end with spices that just simply kick up the flavor. All right, so if you're ready, let's get into it. Hope Warshaw, a buddy of mine, a certified diabetes care and education specialist who lives in Asheville, North Carolina, once said, "Food is a powerful tool to keep blood sugar or glucose levels in check, and making healthy choices can help you avoid pre-diabetes or, in fact, reduce your chances for progressing from pre-diabetes to type 2 diabetes. And it will help manage your glucose levels if you already have the disease." So with that in mind, I thought we'd just talk about some of my favorite ways to keep your blood sugars from spiking. And in fact, these foods and ideas about eating might help you even lower your blood sugar. But everyone's different. Always consult your physician and your diabetic educator to make sure that you are on the right track. But these are some of the things that have worked really well for me. So first, let me take the mystery out of carbohydrates. And let's talk about the types of carbs. Carbohydrates simply are chains of sugar. Pure sugar. Anytime you eat foods that contain carbohydrates, your blood sugar increases. However, not all carbohydrates affect blood sugar at the same time. And there's really two main types of carbohydrates. Simple carbs. These are broken down quickly and thus provide quick energy to the body. And then there's complex carbs. Just like they sound, they're made up of long, complex chains of sugar, which makes them harder to break down, which simply means when you eat a complex carb, they break down slowly in your body, keeping your blood sugars from spiking. So whenever you can, make part of a healthy diabetic lifestyle diet more complex carbs, because they just digest slower, keeping your blood sugars from spiking. Whereas simple carbs, like a potato, for example, or a candy bar, for example, will spike your blood sugars. Remember, it's not all about simple sugar, it's about the carbohydrates. So let's get right into it. I love dark leafy greens. And you've likely heard that dark leafy greens are good for you. Well, they are. They're rich in vitamin A, C, and K, as well as minerals like iron and calcium. They also are low in carbs, high in fiber, which again aids in your blood sugar control. So anytime you can have dark leafy greens as part of a healthy diabetic lifestyle way of eating, you are doing amazing. So try to have dark leafy greens, a dark salad, with some maybe balsamic vinegar and oil dressing. Something simple and delicious that will really help, like dark leafy greens. And non-starchy vegetables are rich in fiber, low in carbs, and blood sugar friendly. Because they aren't starchy, they have lots of fiber, and they won't cause a blood sugar spike. Foods high in fiber will tend to not spike your blood sugars. Now, some of my favorite examples of a non-starchy veggie would be onions, mushrooms, zucchini, broccoli, celery, Brussels sprouts. They're just amazing, and they're wonderfully roasted. I have lots of recipes on the website, happydiabetic.com, for roasted vegetables. And they're excellent sautéed with a combination to mix into pasta, like onion, garlic, broccoli, and zucchini. Now, I know what you're thinking. I said the evil word, pasta. Listen. If you're living a healthy, diabetic-friendly lifestyle, everything in moderation. Pasta can be a very great choice as a way to eat healthy. But again, it's all about moderation. I'm not talking about 5 cups of pasta. I'm talking about a reasonable portion mixed with lots of fresh vegetables and maybe some protein like chicken or salmon. All right, let's move on. All right, my next favorite category of foods would be low glycemic fruits. So those are going to be sweet without causing a blood sugar spike. Most fruits naturally have a low glycemic index because of the fructose and fiber that they contain, such as apples, pears, oranges, berries, grapefruits. These are just a few examples. And I love to mix these fruits into oatmeal for a healthy breakfast, or my wife Cindy loves Greek yogurt with all kinds of fruit in it. It's her jam, snacky snack of choice. So, when I was first diagnosed with diabetes, I thought, oh my gosh. Matter of fact, I even had a doctor tell me one time, hey, easy on the fruit. It's full of sugar. But the reality is, everything in moderation. Fruit is a healthy part of a diabetic lifestyle way of eating. But you're not going to eat 5 apples a day or 4 oranges in an hour. Everything in moderation. That really is the key. And fruit, berries, strawberries, raspberries, blackberries, they're part of a very healthy diabetic style of eating. Now, this is a controversial topic in terms of food. Whole grains, bread. People say, oh my gosh, there's so much carbohydrates in bread. Well, there is, but I don't eat anything that's white and highly processed. So for me, it's all going to be about whole grains and whole grains in everything. So whole grains are low in glycemic index. Unlike processed refined grains like white flour, things that are highly processed, whole grains are unrefined and therefore contain the germ and the bran part of the grain. These parts provide high levels of fiber, which helps slow the release of sugar into the bloodstream. So listen, whole grains, it's really the way to go. Whole wheat and white bread actually have the same amount of carbohydrates. The real difference is white bread digests very quickly, spiking your blood glucose. Whole grains and whole grain breads, they dissolve very slowly, keeping your blood sugars from spiking. So when you can, choose anything with whole grains. Listen, just flip over the package of bread. Read the label. You'll see exactly how much fiber there is. And obviously, try to buy bread with the highest amount of fiber. Now, it's not only about the bread. Some common whole grain foods are brown rice, quinoa, arameth, oats, and whole grain bread, as I've talked about. Oats are whole grains that have been shown to improve glycemic control and insulin sensitivity, which in turn helps keep your blood sugar levels low. That's what we're after, lower blood sugar levels. We love to make overnight oats. We make it easy and quick for breakfast. For anything you'd pair with toast, try using whole grain bread. My next area to chat about with you is healthy fats. Fats help slow your digestion, which delays the absorption of carbohydrates into the blood. Adding healthy fats to your meals not only helps you stay fuller longer, it also keeps blood sugars from spiking. And some examples of healthy fats include olive oil, extra virgin olive oil, regular olive oil, avocado oil, seeds like chia, flax, sunflower. Try making your own salad dressing using olive oil and balsamic vinegar. Simple and easy. 3 parts oil, 1 part balsamic vinegar. Add a little mustard, a little garlic. It would be an amazing simple dressing and a great way to add flavor to the leafy greens and all of the dishes that you love to eat. All right, so we have to talk about protein sources. You know, proteins like fat helps slow digestion, which delays the absorption of carbohydrates into the blood. And because protein takes longer to break down, it helps keep you fuller. So some really typical protein sources in my list include quinoa, beans and rice, soy products, eggs, dairy, lean meats, chicken, grass-fed beef. Those are some amazing protein sources. And in episode 56, listen to my interview with Monty Bottens, an amazing grass-fed farmer who lives very close to me, my very good friend. I think you'll find that to be super interesting because we love grass-fed beef here at the Happy Diabetic Chef Kitchen. So I know this is hard to believe, but I recently signed up for Medicare. Now what about my Libre 2 system from Abbott? As my pharmacy was trying to figure out all the complicated paperwork and getting a little frustrated, so was I. So what did I do? I called US Med to see if there was a better way, and I found out there is. Their motto is better service, better care. It's what they call white glove service. And I was worn out by having to make multiple trips to my pharmacy and not get what I needed. And I only discovered that the orders were not ready. There were long lines, we need to call your doc. Excuses after excuses. I hated that the most. So head over to usmed.com/happydiabetic. Are you ready for US Med to always provide you 90 days worth of supplies and fast free shipping? They carry everything from insulin pumps and diabetes testing supplies to the latest CGMs, Freestyle Libre 2 and 3, and the Dexcom G6 with all their updates. You know my love for the Libre 2 system, and US Med is the number one distributor for Freestyle Libre systems nationwide. If you're just starting out with Medicare like me, US Med should be your very next call. They accept Medicare nationwide and a broad private insurance coverage, over 800 private insurers, and an A-plus rating with the Better Business Bureau. If you're looking for supplies, everything from insulin pumps, diabetes testing supplies, to the latest CGMs, and you're looking for better service, easier service, delivered right to your door, usmed.com/happydiabetic might be just what you're looking for. Simply call this number, 888-885-0012, or Go to usmed.com/happydiabetic. Don't wait any longer. Okay, everybody, welcome back to the podcast. Lastly, I want to talk about one of my favorite snacky snacks, and that's nuts. Nuts are full of unsaturated fats, which are generally considered the healthiest fats. So the nuts that are high in unsaturated fats could include walnuts, almonds, pistachios, love them in the shell, pecans, and peanuts. I love to have a little bit of peanut butter on some celery or some carrots for a great snacky snack. And sometimes I'll add walnuts or pecans to oatmeal or my granola mix. So those are the foods and those are the things that I do to make sure that my blood sugars stay in check. Okay, one more topic. Sorry, but I can't not talk about flavor without spices. Now, you know, I love cooking with spices, and you should too. Full of flavor, with no carbohydrates at all. It's just pure flavor. And there are many spices out there that can complement any dish that you're making. And for me, my arsenal of spices that I keep very close by, oregano, basil, Italian seasoning, rosemary, garlic powder, granulated garlic. I just love those flavors in combination. It's almost got this Mediterranean feel to it. So keep your spices close by and have fun using it. And remember, spices don't last forever. And the easiest way to tell if your spices are on point is to simply smell. If it smells like a wet, soggy dog, throw them away. If it smells like the herb that's in the container, like oregano or basil or rosemary, you are good to go. So enjoy cooking, enjoy healthy cooking with lots of delicious flavors. Spices, high on my list. Look, I know it's not easy. Eating healthy can be a challenge, but it's not complicated. I know you can do it. Look, every day I wake up and I say to myself, Robert, you've got to do better today than you did yesterday. And that's really what it's all about. And I'm going to challenge you to do exactly the same thing. It's time now for the recipe of the podcast. I'm calling this Holly's Sweet Balsamic Onion Jam of Love recipe. It is absolutely amazing. Let's get into the kitchen and start cooking. Okay, Holly's Sweet Balsamic Onion Jam of Love recipe. You'll find it on the website at happydiabetic.com under the blog. Just search for onion jam. But here's the basic recipe. You're going to need a pot, a Dutch oven, cutting board, and a sharp knife. Now, this recipe works really great with frozen onions, too. And depending on your cooking journey, the cooking time may vary. The final cook time may be up to 1 hour. All right, so here's what you're going to need. 2 tablespoons of olive oil. 2 pounds of mixed sweet onions. You can use yellow, you can use white, you can use red, whatever you like. But you're going to need about 6 to 7 cups. Now, I know what you're thinking, especially after you cut them all and you start crying. This looks like a lot of onions. Well, it really is, but it's going to cook down into a beautiful onion jam. You're going to need 6 to 7 cloves of thinly sliced garlic, 1/2 cup of dry red wine, 3 tablespoons of very good quality balsamic vinegar, 1 cup of brown sugar, light or dark, 1/2 cup of honey, and a little salt and pepper. And basically what you're going to do is you're going to peel the onions and you're going to dice them small or thinly sliced or both, any combination. The fun thing about this recipe is turn it into something that says who you are. You're going to add the olive oil to the Dutch oven or the heavy pot over medium heat. Add the onions and the garlic and stir occasionally and cook covered for about 20 to 30 minutes. Then you're going to remove the lid and add the red wine, balsamic vinegar, brown sugar, and honey. So we're going to cover and cook it again for another 45 to 60 minutes over very low to medium heat, stirring occasionally. You want the onions to caramelize, dark golden color, soft, and the majority of the liquid will be evaporated. And give it a final salt and pepper seasoning. Now, when you go on my website, you'll see pictures of what I did, and you'll see exactly the color that you're looking for. This is a happy diabetic recipe of love. I hope you'll enjoy it. Our podcast is produced and engineered by Jason Lewis. Our theme music by the Happy Diabetic Kitchen Band. And, of course, our kitchen mascots, Scout and Tucker. And it's snowing here today in Iowa. So they're cuddled up on the sofa, just hanging out. Well, thanks for tuning in. And let me leave you with this thought. Make a difference in someone's life today, and you will never regret it. All right, everybody, have a great day. And remember, no one loves you more than me.